But I remember what we have to do for the most part. And I remember what we found out. There's a lot of stuff going on. The big thing, though, is we have to figure out how to get into the quantum tower, because that gives us the last bit of knowledge we're going to need to get into the quantum, you know, moon teleporty thingy. Gotta go to Brittle Hollow, and I think we're going to go back to the old. I don't know anything about the Interloper. I haven't heard anything about it. We don't know anything about Hollow's Lantern. I don't even think we can get onto Hollow's Lantern. But I know I'm Brittle Hollow. Apparently there's more at the observatory. And there's more at the Tower of Quantum Knowledge. There's more to explore at the old settlement. Maybe we'll find a clue there. Maybe it'll just connect us to something else. I don't know. Well, I've got eyes on the, quantum moon, so... As long as we have the picture, we should be fine. Well, we just crashed into the moon. But that's fine. Because we're here. Hit me. We're on Ember Twin. Oh, I think I understand. The moon always mirrors the location it's by. The rule of the sixth location. I still have no idea what that means. apparently at Brittle Hollow now. Same probe. Can I even get out of this once I'm inside? Yes, this is the same probe. Okay. Hey, Ivan. What's up? I'm trying to figure out this moon fuckery. Now this is Timberhearth. Must close the door. Okay. Yeah, I don't know. I'm done with Destiny. I'm not getting it. Okay, we're here. We're at the sun. Is the thing still gonna be here? It is. Please be gone. How do I get this to go away? Ugh. the star blows. What do you mean? Oh, like, wait for the sun to be exploding? I'd be sitting here for 22 minutes waiting for that to happen. This is supposed to move when I'm not looking at it, so I don't understand. Lights were off. Timber hearth. There's obviously something I'm missing. I just don't know what it is. Sixth location. No, we're back here again, and recall the rule of the sixth location. So there's something we're missing. Obviously. Maybe what's going on is the quantum stone is teleporting everywhere I'm teleporting. So I need to take a snapshot. Can we not move just because I took a picture? Do I need to... What am I supposed to do? Okay. Alright. Looking for the ship. There we go. Obviously, I have no idea what the hell is going on. Apparently, there was more at the observatory to learn, too. But we need to go through the South Pole or something like that to get there. Oh yeah, we went through the angler world. Basically what was going on was anglerfish. We didn't find out anything super important. No, actually, we found out that those are broken, so we need to do this. But we found out that something jellyfish, something, you know, something jellyfish. Wait, no, this is the way to the observatory. Something about the jellyfish that you could go through it and it would protect you from stuff. Okay. So if I remember correctly, this is... Yeah. We never did this last time. That's what that is. That's the signal, and it's everywhere. At all times. It's an orbit around the sun, but in like a weird infinite range. It could be anywhere, or it is everywhere. Okay. Would I play Borderlands 3? I have played a little bit. I got it to play with a friend, and we haven't really played at all yet. Cause the first time we tried, it was broken and not working. So, took a bit, and apparently he doesn't really want to play now, so... That is a scammer. Oh, I didn't expect this to fall through just right yet. I might be able to swing my way around it. I'm gonna hit something very hard in a minute. Because I had to keep speed. No, not through that. Okay, just suck me up, fam. I had fuel right now. Alright. We've only got so much time. Probably not enough time to do anything. I'm probably gonna die trying this. But that is the fucking Quantum Tower right there. Yeah, we're gonna die. I'm gonna have to wait on the fucking tower to get sucked through. Now that I know for a fact that it does get sucked through. Yeah, I mean, obviously it's possible for cross-platform to be a thing. Companies don't want to do it, I guess. They want to sell multiple copies of their game because they're greedy. Is that all we learned? The white hole station from here. Or we can just go fly into the black hole. I don't think that's true. I think there's other games that have cross-platform. Need to find a place to fly through the planet into the black hole. I'm pretty sure there's something else. Now we just wait here till it gets sucked through. Did I never meet the banjo player? Sure, go for it. What do you call a pickled deer? I don't know. I don't like that joke. Not a fan. It's too, cheesy. I'm not even gonna repeat the punchline. Person is Trent is on Emberglade. So so that's probably from Ash Twin, if I had to guess. Well, whose camps have we seen? Church camp, yeah. Gabbro on the island. Ryback. I may just not have scanned the person. I don't think I have any need to go search out any of those guys. Blah, just sitting in space. Once we know the knowledge of this sixth image. We should be good to go. This is getting very close. Did it just... No. No, it couldn't have just gone into the white hole. Oh, there it is. Okay. Yeah, just... The light bent around it. That one doesn't have the tower. I wonder what is up with that thing. We haven't found anything out about it. It might just be a comet. Oh, the rocks come out with them, huh? Land on it? I will eventually. I have landed on it once, and it, like, melted when it got close to the sun, but I couldn't find anything on it. There was probably something. I'm just hoping none of these things that are coming out hit my ship. This reminds me a lot of Hard Space. All these big moving parts. Hard Space is, it's a game where you float around in space and you take ships apart by, like, cutting pieces off of them and you salvage it and whatnot. It's pretty cool. It gets a little repetitive. I'm waiting for it to get updated a bunch before I play it some more. I had some fun with it, and now I just want to wait. Wait for it to get released out of early access or something. Yeah, I did stream it. Is that our boy? I feel like it's gonna come out on this side. Hey, look, part of the bridge. How does a black hole end up at the center of a planet anyways? I don't think that's possible. Ba-doop-a-doop, boop, ba-doop-a-dee-boop. Achievement unlocked harmonic convergence? I definitely did not converge them. It's a nice little tomb. Keep on waiting. So, if this, now that I'm thinking about it, if that symbol is for the signal, which is, okay, I thought that was coming at me for a minute. If that symbol is for the signal, which is out in, you know, orbit somewhere really far away, then that means that It means that the thing orbiting around the sun is something completely different. And I thought that's what we were doing this whole time. I thought we were figuring out how to get to the sun. The quantum moon will carry you just as it carried me and many in our clan before me. The moon's sixth and most secret location. You'll be aided in your pilgrimage by the shrine our clan built on the quantum moon. But remember this final rule. To explore the sixth location, the shrine must be on the moon's north pole. Okay. Understood. How do I drop this? Please. Oh, I don't need to drop it. There was. I haven't needed to roll that much. Make this journey not only for ourselves, but also to honor the members of our clan who came before us. Those who, after the crash that brought them to this system, became stranded on Brittle Hollow and Ember Twin, with no communication between these two groups of survivors. These Nomai looked upward from two different planets and saw the same wandering moon visiting their skies. It was this moon, the Quantum Moon, that kept their curiosity alive during this long period of hardship. After the two divided groups were able to reunite, it became our clan's united goal to find and visit the Quantum Moon. This took time, and many Nomai who dreamed of seeing the Quantum Moon died before we discovered how to make the journey. When you reach the Quantum Moon, recall these Nomai and carry their curiosity onward with you. Okay. Will do. We know how to do it now. There should be a touchstone somewhere. Maybe I've missed it. Okay. What's going on with the interloper before we die? Or alternatively, we just get sucked into the sun, I guess. That's fine. So now we know that the The shrine has to be on the North Pole. That makes things a lot simpler. It's all about knowledge. Like, if you knew what to do, you could do it right at the beginning of the game, or you could just stumble upon it. Must be the probe. Okay. So we need to get to the North Pole. Whichever planet does not have this thing at the North Pole. I guess that should have been my first clue. I never looked over at the planet map, but I assume it, this probably isn't close enough. Nope. Yeah, like, it doesn't change where we've been, so... Riddle Hall is no good. Let's see if Ash Gwen is better. Alright. Culmination of all the knowledge of the Nomai. Take us to wherever this is. Thank you. Oh shit! Dude, a living Nomai. Who are you? What? I don't understand exactly. I don't get it. Identify you. Okay, you're you. Explain you. Confused. Yeah, explain the eye of the universe to me. There's fundamental uncertainty throughout the universe. Normally, this uncertainty is only observable on a very small scale. As one approaches the eye, however, that uncertainty grows enormously. The quantum womb probably exhibits macroscopic quantum behavior because of its proximity to the eye. Shards that broke off the quantum moon have a similar effect. Conscious observation forces a quantum object to collapse to a single possibility. But what would happen if a conscious observer somehow entered the eye itself? Over time, this has become my clan's greatest question. Okay, identify you. I am on my first pilgrimage to the quantum moon. All Nomai and my clan make this journey when we come of age. Even though the eye cannot be reached from here, the quantum moon remains special to us, as it carries us nearer to the eye than any other place we know. I've journeyed here to be close to the eye. While the eye is obscured from our sight, we can see the quantum moon's reflection of the eye in the sky above us. Explain me. I imagine your purpose here is the same as mine, to learn about and to find the Eye of the Universe. I'm unsure how you arrived here, however. Perhaps you come from another star system, as my clan originally did. Okay, so he doesn't have the answers about me. Have you encountered a quantum shard on another planet? The shards look the same as the quantum moon's surface does now while at the Eye. From this, we can reasonably infer the quantum moon's natural state is as we see it now, and that the eye is its primary location. Given that quantum moon is the eye's moon, it's likely that any characteristics the moon exhibits are also exhibited by the eye itself. The quantum moon and its shards, for instance, are quantum, thus the eye is likely also quantum. In fact, the moon is probably quantum because its proximity to the eye made it quantum. Okay. identify me. I don't know who you are. I've never met one of your kind before. It's an honor to speak with you. I particularly admire your four eyes. There are many questions I would ask if I could comprehend your language. You have my gratitude for understanding mine. I am Solonomai. My clan arrived in this solar system before my birth, and now we call it home. But you're all dead, though. We are orbiting the Eye of the Universe now, although we cannot see it, only the Quantum Moon's reflection of it. The Eye is older than the universe itself, and my clan believes it dwells in an extremely distant orbit around the star system. This is the Quantum Moon where we are both standing. Despite also orbiting other celestial bodies, the Quantum Moon is the Eye of the Universe's moon. To ask you. So I guess it's time to do what needs to be done by me. Wait, did this take us back? Back to Timberhearth? No. Gonna hurt. Whoa. Okay. Well then, found feldspar. You found feldspar, and they're in dark bramble. Stars above, this is wonderful news. Thank you. Thank you for finding them. That feldspar didn't immediately join you on your ship and return here is incredibly feldspar of them. We were never entirely sure what feldspar was thinking back then, either. Still, we ought to fish them out of that dreadful place with all haste. I'll radio Gossen and have them prepare a ship. It really should be Gossen who brings feldspar home. Again, thank you. You can hardly imagine how profoundly happy I am to hear they're alive and unharmed. Okay. Man, like, I don't have to talk to these people, but it's really great that I can. And that they have, you know, dialogue. Thank you. wearing my spacesuit, dude. Oh, is there shit down here? This pushes me back. This sucks. This sucks! She's gone from suck to blow. I didn't know about this. I just jumped in the geyser for fun. Oh shit, there's no mine stuff here. After closer observation, mining safe site 2A wouldn't be safe for native life dwelling in some of these caves' pools. On the opposite hand, new life. The species is semi-aquatic and very hardy. I was watching them once during a rest and the hours escaped from me. They're fascinating. I wonder what their fourth eye does. Okay, so they knew about us. Oh, nice. They saw us when we were little slugmans. Alright, well, nothing left to do but wait to die. We figured out the quantum moon stuff. Man, I thought we were gonna be done today, but it feels like there's still a lot of stuff I'm missing. I wonder if this still works. Or if this only works if you do it in the time loop. There we go. That's easier than waiting. Okay, so, I mean, what did we really learn? Maybe I was supposed to jump in from the South Pole on the Quantum Moon. I don't know. The moon is the eye of the universe's moon. There's still more at the Ash Twin, apparently. Oh, you can see the connections. Okay. There is a way to safely travel to the sun station, but how? Broke when the ship crashed in Dark Bramble. You know what? Maybe we go back to Dark Bramble. Try to find the vessel. It's gonna take us too close to the sun. It already is. I didn't abort the autopilot. Shit. No wonder we almost flew into the sun. Let's take a look around the outside first to see if we can find the warp. Maybe that's why this is like this. Because the warp core broke inside of it. Slight little bumperoo. Another slight little bumperoo, don't worry. that's fine. Alright. Keeps going into loops of itself. So maybe there's something there. Either that or I've just killed myself. Okay, we stuck in an infinite nightmare. Guess we just kill ourselves again. Oh jeez. That scares the shit out of me every time. I knew it was there too and it scared the shit out of me. I'm not sure what to do now. Like, I feel like I've exhausted all my, my options. I have no idea how to get there. I think I have now is to go to Ashtwin. One of the teleports must be the right thing. There's how many systems in the... There are how many planets in the system? 1, 2, 3, 4. And then 5 if we count that. So that means there should be 5 teleporters. But I think there is a 6 that'll take us to the sun station. There's gotta be. This has got something to do with the gravity cannon. And now that I think about it, it might have something to do with the gravity cannon. Let's try landing in that. No. Here we go. Shuttle is currently resting at the comet. Okay, this is something we haven't messed with before. I fear a situation may be dire. Hypoke and I landed on this comet not long after its arrival in the star system. Our shuttle's equipment heard strange energy readings coming from somewhere beneath the surface. A fissure on the ice on the comet's sunward side. Okay. May just get sucked into the sun here. I might somehow land at the sun station, I don't know. Doesn't look like it. This is the closest I can get to the sun. There's a teleporter. Yeah, there's a teleporter. I got close enough to see that. My assessment is that our plan will either fail explosively or something or other. Time spent away from the station would be beneficial for you both. Really hurt ourselves to get through here. The teleporter room, which is here. But that's fine, as long as we get to where we're going. Should be now. Now? Whoa! Okay. No user commands received for 10 minutes. All systems entering sleep. Increased solar activity detected. Sun station hull integrity approaching critical levels. Closing emergency doors. Warning opens emergency door. Science compels us to explode the sun. Can't we change this? I don't enjoy working in view as such a morbid mission statement. But it's accurate. We're gonna create a supernova for the purpose of scientific progress. That's our mission. Determine if it's possible to prompt the sun to explode. You lack a sense of humor. At least I don't lack a sense of ethics. Kindly refrain from going supernova on me before the sun does. Statue doesn't do anything for me right now. happened? Did the sun station not fire? It fired, Yarrow, but it failed. The sun barely responded. There were infinitesimally small surface level changes, but they were barely visible, even to the third eye. The sun station is useless. It will never and could never cause the sun to explode. I don't know what comes next, my friends. I suppose we must start over, but I'm unsure how to start over. Okay. The comet. Why, I hurt you. I hurt for you, my friends. We all know how hard you both worked. We're well, though disappointed. I may have disagreed with exploding the sun, but I never wished the device would fail. Approximate, 0 minutes, 30 seconds? 30 seconds? That's not enough time! We got what we needed. Oh my god. No, this is not possible. There's the crack. Okay, it's on the front. And, we get sucked into the sun. Okay. Okay, so next step, the comet. We figured out the sun station. Next, we go into the comet. Where, you know, nobody ever came out, but it's okay. Because if we die in there, you know, it doesn't matter. Why did all the Nomai die out anyways? Like, it's not like they did anything as far as we can tell. Wait, so this shuttle, the shuttle that I was using was frozen in this somehow. Oh, shit. Oh, no, 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 no. Let me back in. Okay, so the sun facing side. So we want to look up and see the sun directly with our own eyes. Probably in here. Thank you. Boobadoop boop boop boop, flying into the sun very slowly. One day we'll get there, maybe, I don't know. This is the sun facing side, right? Yes. Okay. Receiving much stronger energy readings now that we're beneath the crust. Whatever it is must lie somewhere below, closer to the comet's center, and I'm starting to think it's more dangerous than we realized. Clary, can you hear us? Yes, but your voices are faint. I fear we will lose communication entirely if you continue any deeper. Yeah, so Pi and Poke died down here. To danger. I have to find one of these that doesn't lead straight into ghost matter. God, this is reminding me a lot of fucking Super Mario 64 right now. Okay. That hole's filled with ghost matter too. Looks like one of them died here, sadly. There's the other. Now what is this? Is this where all ghost matter comes from? Okay. The spherical stone case in here seems to be the source of the energy readings. No, rather, the source is within the stone. I'm detecting some form of exotic matter. The stone is muting our energy readings. They should be 10 times what we're seeing at least. I don't think we want this matter interacting with us. As far as I can tell, direct contact with it would almost certainly be fatal. I've never encountered anything like this casing, but it's all that's worth protecting us from what's inside. We're still dismounted, it's still disturbingly volatile. Whatever the matter inside this stone casing is, it's more than just profoundly unstable. It's under tons of pressure. Look at this density scan. I've never seen anything this tightly compacted before. What is this? This is orders of magnitudes worse than I'd imagined. If this stone were to rupture, the lethal matter would rapidly expand, completely blanketing the star system almost instantaneously. And the pressure is still building as the comet approaches the star system. Okay. The more we know about this, the better our chances of survival. I will learn what I can here. The What did you learn, though? So this eventually will enter the sun. But this doesn't give me any clues on what to do next. It's me. Well, okay, well, I mean, they both died, like, instantly. They never got back to warn anyone. We're still no closer to understanding the Ash Twin Project. Fuck, he got like all crystallized. Well, I'm not sure what to do about that. There's anything I can do. I should probably just go about killing myself. Maybe Ghost Matter did go off or something. That's why all... No, because we would have died too. Ship's log. Tell me things. Sun station was designed to make the sun go supernova. Okay, that's completely... Well, that was, not useful. That ghost matter probably is what killed the sun. Completely lost on what to do now. I feel like I've expended every possible thing I could be doing. I remember what this was. This was... This was something. I was in there. Anyways, apparently there's stuff at the gravity cannon, so I wanna check that out real quick. At that shuttle. I don't remember this. Sometimes as a moon. Okay, we know this. I don't know if I'm actually doing anything here, but, maybe if everything... No, this wouldn't do anything. It just tracks the moon. Side of the planet if I want to find the gravity cannon, I'm guessing. Because I'm not finding it. There it is. Okay. So apparently there's some shit going on with the shuttle. Apparently there's more to discover with the shuttle, but I have no idea what. No, not what I wanted to do. Am I getting sucked into the sun? Closer somehow. That's all I want. I don't think I can get back. Yeah, I'm getting sucked into the sun. Shit. Oh, alright, I think I'm gonna stop for now. I need to, like, take some time to think about what I've done. Let it, like, stew in my brain space. So, I'm gonna end for now. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you later.